Hello, everyone. So, Dan Bailey resigned today with the Minnesota Vikings, and just to go down some statistical things from 2018, he didn't attempt anything from 0 to 19 yards. He was 83.3% from 20 from 29 yards. He only missed one going, 5 for 6. 30 to 39, perfect 11 for 11. And then the real issue kind of came in the 40 to 49 yard range, where he was only hitting 44.4%, where he missed 5 of the field goals, going only 4 for 9, and he missed one of his 2 from 50 plus. Extra points was actually pretty good, as he went from 30 for 31 there. That's 96.8%. Field goal percentage-wise, though, he needs to get better as an overall thing. Mainly in this 40 to 49 range, where ultimately he ended up going 21 or 28 for 75%. Now, that's not good. But he did sign a one-year contract extension with Minnesota today. And that's worth $1 million, but can go up to $2 million in incentives. However, important to point out, only $250,000 in guaranteed money on this one-year deal. And I saw by Chris Thomason, don't know if you guys saw this, but there was a top 51 rule that will actually make his $1 million cap hit a $500,000 cap hit. Helpful. Very helpful when you're talking about this cap situation they have assembled. And by assembled, I kind of mean completely run into the dirt. Now, does he return to the form he had back in Dallas? Probably not. And I do think he should be better, but I'm not thinking he's going to go back to hitting like 95% or whatever it was back in the day. He's probably going to be somewhere in the middle. We're probably looking probably not as bad as 75%, but maybe 80 to 85, perhaps. I think we'd take that after all the stuff we've been through. And I know last year they kind of blame, some of the issues on, Matt Weil hasn't punted in, well, not punted, hasn't held for a while. No? Okay. And it's kind of hard to get that chemistry going when, he came on, what was it, week 3 after, the whole Daniel Carlson missing like 3 field goals overtime. And up in a tie. All the good stuff. That was the 2018 season. And I do think it's, like I said, it is hard to get that chemistry going when he's such a late add and he hasn't really held the ball that long anyway. There's questions as to whether or not he could really hold the ball well. And then you added a new kicker. It's usually not a good deal, especially with how finicky kickers happen to be. And I really do want to reiterate this only $250,000 guaranteed thing on Dan Bailey, because that means a UDFA competition is possible for Dan Bailey. You could look at that like, well, you're only $250,000 in the hole from cutting Dan Bailey. So if you get a guy undrafted who ends up performing better than Dan Bailey and you roll with that over Dan, you're really not hurt by it, which is really good, because I think how this is kind of a year by year thing anyway, especially with us. Like, there's only few kickers who can really get guaranteed spots year by year by year by year. And typically it's pretty good just to take it by year. That's what I think. And the other re-signing that happened was Amir Abdullah yesterday. And his 2018 stats were lackluster. He had one attempt for 1 yard. That's it. Receiving, he was targeted 4 times, caught 3 of those passes for 28 yards. No touchdowns, and kick returning, he had 14 returns for 365 yards, a long of 33, and 26.1 yards per return. So pretty decent at kick returning. And he was a midseason claim off waivers, I think around week 10, I think. And wasn't really used much in Minnesota when we first brought him in, mainly for the kick returning duties. But I think with Rock Thomas getting busted with the whole marijuana thing, you could be looking at, that's why he's here, because Rock Thomas was initially going to be on the roster. Now, who knows? He might just not be on the roster, could be gone. Like, his career could be over because of this, because he was such a low-level player. And really kind of sucks for him, but I think that kind of forced this re-signing of Amir Abdullah, because now you're like, okay, but how do we replace that kind of skill set that we're planning to have? And you kind of have it in Amir Abdullah, where he can return kicks and punts, and he can kind of, you get him in space, he's probably quicker than he is fast, but he's really shifty, he's got all those moves, he's good to go, all the good stuff. And I think it could also spell the end of Marcus Sherrills as a punt returner. He hasn't handled punts since his days at Nebraska, but I do think he has the kind of skill set to really do that. And once again, given the cap situation that Minnesota has kind of made for themselves here, you kind of look at Marcus Sherrills and say, we can't afford a $1.5-2 million cap hit for a guy who's strictly a punt returner anymore. And as good as he is, I don't know if they can do that. So this could potentially spell the end, and I know this is kind of like the whole thing, like, oh, every year everyone's saying Marcus Sherrills won't make the roster, he won't come back, and then he always does, and then all the good stuff, all the yada, yada, yada. At the end of the day, Marcus Sherrills is a Viking. That's how it's been. This is the one time where I think he might not make it, and it's a little saddening because he's been here forever, but at the same time, it's a business. You have to do these kind of things all the time. And Abdullah did sign a one-year contract, and I haven't seen the details yet. I haven't found them. I was kind of hoping, since I was kind of late on this one, since it happened yesterday, that it would happen by now, that those would have come out. But I could not find them. And I imagine it's not much. It's probably not much. It's probably pretty close to minimum with little to no guaranteed money. That's my guess, because once again, there's only so much money Minnesota can give people right now. And yeah, I'd like to know what you guys think down in the comments below. Your thoughts on Bailey, Abdullah, running back situation, all of kickers. I know some people are probably disappointed, like, oh, Guskowski was available. But once again, price range was probably a big deal when it came to these two in particular. And once again, though, I'd like to know what you guys think down in the comments below. It is there for a reason. And until next time, I bet you all too.